University of California, Berkeley. In 1964, that campus was the birthplace of the free speech movement. Those days are gone. On the 1st of February, the students of Berkeley broke out into a full-fledged riot to stop the speech of Milo Yiannopoulos, who was an invited guest to the campus. These delinquents broke windows, set fires, physically assaulted other students who were in line waiting to hear the speech of Milo. A 33-year-old, openly gay, Jewish journalist, an immigrant. A couple of days later, the same thing happened at NYU to comedian Gavin McInnes, also an immigrant. Gavin was pepper sprayed. A professor actually demanded that the police act with violence to beat up Mr. McInnes. These protesters have convinced themselves that they are anti-fascist. In fact, the word fascism is being thrown around quite a bit these days. But who is really acting like fascists? Who is silencing political speech, physically attacking those with divergent views, demanding that every American share one single ideology? Was it not Sarah Silverman who suggested the White House be overthrown by a military coup? Remind me, who are the fascists? But sadly, the real truth is that these violent agitators have little idea about why they march. Theirs is a movement with no cause, a temper tantrum with no purpose. They are a generation lost in space, children being led around like cattle by a corrupted media infrastructure, the propaganda arm of the party of disappointment. If I were wrong, would Hillary Clinton really be their standard bearer? These rioters are being manipulated by big government forces who need them to regain political power. You youngsters are enchanted with socialism. But those ideas are nothing new. History has tested them time and time again, all with the same result. Lenin, Mao, Che Guevara, history's greatest failures. And each of these dictatorships began with young, naive people marching in the streets. There is, however, a revolution happening right now in Europe and America. Citizens are tired of their freedoms being trodden upon by a big central government, or the European Union, or the United Nations. People are tired of open borders, tired of being entangled with other nations with trade deals and alliances that are unequal. They are tired of their own wealth being seized by governments who use it to buy votes or influence. People are crying out for personal freedom, for the individual to be sovereign, for liberty, for men and women to choose their own destiny. And if you had stayed to listen to Milo or Gavin, you may have heard this powerful message. You may even have agreed with some of it, but you were too busy acting like fascists.